Hey guys, my name is Maggie, and today I'm going to tell you a little bit about what people think is our scariest fish, the red-bellied piranha. They've gained a bad reputation for viciously devouring anything in their path within mere seconds. But are they actually as scary as everyone thinks they are? The short answer is no.
These fish get a bad reputation in part because of some exaggerated claims made about them following one of Teddy Roosevelt's expeditions to the Amazon. His guide showed him starving piranhas taking down a large animal in a short period of time. This story then inspired a movie in the 1970s that only confirmed people's suspicions of the piranha as a man-eating terror. However, this is a gross misrepresentation of a beautiful and usually quite docile fish. Piranhas are native to the Amazon River Basin, where they struggle to survive changes to their habitat during the dry season. This land can go for months without rain at certain times of the year, which reduces the piranhas' normally large swimming areas to small, stagnant pools little bigger than puddles. These conditions make competition for food and resources fierce, as the fish can go for a long time without a meal. This means that if something falls in the water, they will use their strong jaws and razor-sharp interlocking teeth to rip it apart as quickly as possible and get their fill. They tend to travel in groups more for protection than to take down larger prey, but then end up stuck in ever-shrinking pools together trying to fend off starvation. Though people tend to think of these fish as fearsome predators, they are actually very valuable to their ecosystem as scavengers. They are opportunistic feeders with a very varied diet. Though they might hunt for small fish, insects, and invertebrates, they also consume carrion and even plant matter. Piranhas have also been known to nip at the fins of some larger fish for sustenance. Here at the Greater Cleveland Aquarium, they eat a mix of fish, shellfish, and a special, very nutritious gel diet. Though stories and the media have portrayed these fish as ferocious killers that should be feared, they are actually quite docile, when well fed, and will avoid conflict if possible. I hope I've debunked some of the myths surrounding these widely misunderstood creatures. Make sure to check them out on your next visit to the Greater Cleveland Aquarium. We look forward to seeing you soon!